Let us discuss about Ewing sarcoma. It is small cell, small round cell tumor. It arises from, the origin is actually not known, but it's thought to be they originate from primitive neuroectodermal cells. Dermal cells without differentiation. These cells will not undergo any differentiation. Okay, these tumor cells, they do not undergo any differentiation. This Ewing sarcoma is of three types. One is classic Ewing sarcoma or bone sarcoma. Bone Ewing sarcoma. Next one is soft tissue Ewing sarcoma. Third one is primitive neuroectodermal tumor. Remember, this primitive neuroectodermal tumor has got worst prognosis. We'll now discuss about bone sarcoma. Okay, bone sarcoma. The bone Ewing sarcoma. Okay. It is the most malignant tumor. They arise in the marrow of long bones, mainly long bones like humerus, femur, tibia, fibula, but it can also occur in some flat bones like pelvis or calcaneum, and it occurs at very young age, from 5 to 20 years. It undergoes metastasis. It is very malignant tumor, and if take the genetics of this tumor, there is translocation of 11 and 22 chromosomes between these two chromosomes, and one more is between 24 and 12. These two are the involved in the pathogenesis of Ewing sarcoma of bone. Next, if take clinical manifestation, they present with mass on the bone, with pain, tenderness, fever, anemia, leukocytosis, with all these symptoms. Okay, if take morphology on the x-ray also, what happens is, we'll see some osteolytic lesions on x-ray, and we'll also see subperiosteal reactive bone formation. This is about clinical manifestation. Coming to morphology. If take morphology, this Ewing sarcoma of bone, the mass will be, suppose it is bone marrow, the mass will come like this from bone marrow. Okay, this is periosteum. The bone the tumor comes from marrow. Grossly, there it appears as gray-white in color, and there are some areas of necrosis in the tumor. Necrosis, hemorrhage will be there. Okay. This is morphology. This is marrow. See how this tumor is growing. It becomes very wide, and it gives a pressure on surrounding tissues. Okay, this is wide and soft. And this sarcoma, this Ewing sarcoma, they mostly arises from diaphysis of bone or metaphysis. But most commonly they arise from diaphysis. Okay, see. And in the tumor we find some necrotic areas and hemorrhagic areas also. Necrotic and hemorrhagic areas also. If take microscopic picture, we can see that the entire tumor mass is divided into lobes by fibrous septa, by this fibrous septa, and this fibrous septa is rich in vascular tissues. Okay, this tumor is divided into lobes by fibrous septa. See, these tumor cells, they are very round in where they are small and round. They look as if they are lymphocytes, but they are not lymphocytes. And between the two cells, there is no reticulin fibers. Okay, reticulin is not present. And if take individual cells, the cell, see, they are ill-defined borders. They got ill-defined borders. See, we cannot identify the borders. See, we cannot see the borders. So in the cells, they got ill-defined borders. In the cytoplasm, you see, the cytoplasm is very clear. Clear cytoplasm is there. This cytoplasm, it contains glycogen. This clear cytoplasm is due to glycogen. This glycogen is acid-passed pass-through. And if take nucleus, in the nucleus, we will see salt, pepper, chromatin. And we will also see one pattern called homorite pseudorosetti formation. You will see what is this. See, there is fibrin material here. This is central fibrillary space. Around this, the tumor cells are arranged. This pattern is called homorite pseudorosetti formation. This is, the cells are arranged in a circle around central fibrillary space. Okay, this is about microscopic structure. If take metastasis, they metastasize the hematogenous spread. Okay, hematogenous spread to lungs, brain, liver, to other bones also. Okay, and as said before, it is more malignant and it occurs in very young age. We have to be very cautious because it occurs at a very young age, less than 20 years. But sometimes it can go behind up to 30 years also. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please hit the like button and encourage me to do more videos. I am new to this YouTube. I am very interested in teaching. That's why I started preparing these videos. Thank you for watching.